Welcome back to my English learning YouTube channel. My dear viewers and subscribers, I am discussing questions of interrogative sentences in my videos. So, the title of the topic is being written on the board. Voice change of interrogative sentences. Okay, I have already discussed so many roles of interrogative sentences in my previous videos. So today it will be the discussion of the interrogative sentences which are started with who. Okay, everybody of us know that the questions of the question word who always becomes a little different from other question or other interrogative sentences. Okay, so I am writing some sentences on the board to make everything easy and simple and for your better understanding. Okay, so the very first sentence I am writing here, who built the Taj Mahal? Okay, so this is a famous sentence all over the world. It is a sentence of active voice where I have written who built the Taj Mahal. So if we want to change a sentence into passive one having who, then what should we do? Actually, the rule of the voice sentence is like this. The object of the active voice sentence should be the subject. Okay, in this regard we will write the Taj Mahal, okay, the subject of the sentence. Then it is built, that means the verb is in its past tense, that is why we have to write was. And then past participle form of the main verb, so it will be built only. The Taj Mahal was built, and according to the rule of passive there will be by, and the subject must be written as an object. Okay, so the object of who is whom. So the Taj Mahal was built by whom? So this is the sentence which we may write as the passive form of the sentence who built the Taj Mahal. But this sentence is not grammatically correct, it is totally incorrect. Okay, because in my previous videos I told you that WH question word can never go to the end of the sentence. They must be put at the very beginning of the sentence to start the sentence. Okay, we can never change their position. So, try to understand this wrong sentence or incorrect sentence. And if we modify this sentence, then we will find a good and correct sentence of the passive form who built the Taj Mahal. So, if we take this part to the very beginning or to the very start of the sentence, so what will happen? So let me show the sentence, or let me explain the sentence by taking by whom at the very beginning of the sentence. Okay, so I am writing by whom. Then as the sentence in its question, that means as the sentence is an interrogative one, so what will come before the subject? The subject here is the Taj Mahal. Okay, so what should we do now? We have to write by whom was the Taj Mahal. So what, that means was, the vibhav has come before the subject. So by whom was the Taj Mahal, the Taj Mahal built. Okay, B-U-I-L-T. This one will be the passive voice sentence of the active voice sentence, who built the Taj Mahal, by whom was the Taj Mahal built. So I hope you have understood the sentence. Ready? At first I have written the sentence incorrectly, and as per the rule of passive form, that object must be made subject, then a verb will come. past participle form of the main verb comes. Then we write by and the subject. Here the subject is the question word itself. Who? It has become whom. That means the object form of who is whom. And before that I have written by. But this is not a correct sentence because it is an interrogative sentence. So if a sentence with who is to transform into passive one, then we have to use by whom at the very beginning of the sentence to start the sentence. Okay, so you have already understood what I have done here. So now this is the beginning and this one is also the end of the learning. Okay, but from today we will write or we will start a sentence of passive voice containing who with by whom. Okay, but by whom, how by whom comes to the very beginning of the sentence, we have already seen with the structure of this sentence. So from right now, wherever and whenever we find a sentence started with who and may be turned into passive or should be turned into passive, should be started with by whom. Okay, so who built the Taj Mahal, by whom was the Taj Mahal built. According to the tense, we will write the passive form of such sentences. Now I am writing another sentence. Who wrote the Kirtan Ghosa? So this is another question, by whom, where the sentence is who wrote the Kirtan Ghosa. So this time we will directly and start the sentence by whom, not by this way. We will not waste our time because we have already understood the rule. So there will be by whom. By, and the verb is wrote. It is in past tense. That is why was will come, because the object here is the Kirtan Ghosa. It is a singular number noun. So by whom was the Kirtan Ghosa? Kirtan Ghosa written. The past participle form of the main verb write is written. Okay. By whom was the Kirtan Ghosa written? Okay. So who can trust the liar? Who can trust a liar? So this is also a very important sentence and we have to change it into passive. How? So there will be by whom. There will be by whom. How by whom comes before? We have already got the point, or I have already explained how it comes to the beginning of the sentence. Then there is can. We have to write this can because auxiliary verb must be written before the subject to keep the interrogative sentences nature intact. Okay, by whom can a liar be trusted? Yes, there is can be will come in passive form. So by whom can a liar be trusted? Okay. Again, who has broken the window pane? Who has broken the window pane? So this is another sentence which is written in present perfect tense. So we have to start the sentence with by whom. It will be by whom, and the object here is the window pane. So has will come before it. So by whom has the window pane, has the window pane. And as there is has, or as it is in present perfect tense, been will come in passive form. Okay, so by whom has the window pane been broken? by whom has the window pane been broken. So we have got the point, and I hope your conception is very clear with the examples which have already been written on the board, and how change takes place in passive form with the question word who. So in every case we have to use by whom to make a sentence passive containing who. Okay, so the sentences are: who built the Taj Mahal? By whom was the Taj Mahal built? Who wrote the Kirtan Ghosa? By whom was the Kirtan Ghosa written? Who can trust a liar? By whom can a liar be trusted? Who has broken the window pane? By whom has the window pane been broken? Okay. Yet I am writing some more sentences in this context, where I will write some sentences of passive voice also by using by whom, which we have to change into active. Okay. So here I am writing by whom are you taught English. So this is a sentence of passive voice where I have written by whom are you taught English. So if we want to change it into active, what should we do? We have to drop by it, okay, at the very first sight. Then we have to write who in place of whom. So it will be who. Again, as it is the direct question, not in negative form, so directly we have to use the verb. And as the vibhav has come are here, that is why the sentence is definitely in present indefinite tense. So the verb must be in its present form. It will be who teach. Okay. Then you is the object here. It will remain here. Who teach you, and English should be written as it is here. Okay. This one will be the active one. But here we have to see a thing more, and which I always tell you to be very careful in case of present indefinite tense, because this is a sentence of present indefinite tense. If we write who teach you English, it will be incorrect, because it may be the singular subject. That is why it will be who teaches you English. Okay, who teaches you English. So I hope you have got the point, or you are getting the idea of the passive form containing who or by whom. Okay. Now I am writing another sentence which will be started with whom. Whom do, okay, whom do you want to meet? So this is another sentence which has been started with whom. So here, whom do you want to meet? This is a sentence of active voice, and which has been started with whom. Now what should we do? So whom is the object itself. Okay, whom do you want to meet? So what should we do to make it passive? We have to write now who here. Okay, so who is wanted to meet, who is wanted to meet by you. Okay, who is wanted, that means whom do you want. It will be in its passive form. Who is wanted? Who is wanted to meet by you? It will be the passive form of the sentence. Whom do you want to meet? That means who is wanted to meet by you? So you have to see this sentence very closely, and sometimes such sentences are asked in our examination, and we must avoid the mistake. And if we watch these sentences very closely, then it will be a wise thing, okay, to make the answer correct. Okay, now I am writing another sentence. Who will bail the cat? Who will bail the cat? This is another sentence where I have written who will bail the cat. It is in active voice, and likewise other sentence, it will be by whom will the cat. Then there will be be, as there is will, by whom will the cat be bailed. Okay, B-E-L-L-E-D. So this is the passive form of the sentence. Will bail the cat, by whom will the cat be bailed. Okay, then I may write some other sentences. By whom were you cheated? Okay, by whom were you cheated? This is a passive voice sentence where I have written by whom were you cheated. So if we want to change it into active, then what should we do? We must write who, and where will be omitted, by will be omitted, because it is in past tense. That is why it will be who cheated you. Who cheated you? This one will be the active voice of the sentence by whom were you cheated. Okay. So I may write some more sentences as examples, because it is a very hot topic of grammar to change from active to passive or from passive to active, containing the sentence or starting the sentence with who or whom, by whom. Okay. So this is a very important topic of grammar to be discussed. Okay. Now I am writing some more sentences, more examples for you, for our better convenience. So I am writing here, who does not know him. So here we have to observe one thing, that the verb here is know, and in passive form know verb always takes two with it. So what should we do now? At this point we must not write by whom. Who must be whom, but at this point we must not write by whom. Definitely we have to write to whom. To whom. Okay. To whom. And the sentence is in present indefinite tense. That is why to whom. To whom is he. It will be him. And the subject form of him will be he. So it will be to whom is he not. There will be not, because it is a negative sentence. So to whom is he not known. To whom is he not known. Okay. To whom is he not known. So very simple. But we have to remember, as the verb is know, there will not be by whom. That means we cannot say by whom is he not known. But we have to say to whom is he not known. Okay. Who can do the sum? So this is another sentence in question or in interrogative where we can write by whom. Okay. There will be by whom. So there must be can. Can is present here. Can the sum be done? Okay. By whom can the sum be done? So I hope You are getting the point and you have already understood what I have discussed today. So I want to finish the voice sense of interrogative sentence here today with this video. So thank you for watching my videos.